Hello everyone! So today we're going to make something very special and exciting. We're going to draw a new window, like your very own personal window that has not been there before. We're going to make a new, we're going to develop a new family, and we're going to make it parametric. So if you've been hesitant to drawing your own families before, don't be scared. I'm going to show you step by step how it's done, and in the end you can be very proud of yourself. Of course, this doesn't only apply for windows. You can use the things I talk about in the video to draw your own doors or some kind of building elements, like some special foundation or some fixtures. So let's get started.
Here we have this building with this sad facade. As you can see, no windows. So let's give this building a little bit of daylight with some newly created windows. To do this, we go to File, New, Family. And you see, the good thing is we don't have to start from zero. Revit gives you all these family templates with some kind of pre-settings that you can work with. Now, if you don't know what the right template for you is, or if you want to create something very complex with no pre-settings in the way, I would always recommend you to go with the generic model template. But today we are going to use the window template. We click on open. And as you can see, Revit already gives you some kind of orientation, where the exterior side is going to be and the interior side, and you have this default wall piece. If we open an elevation, we can see that this wall piece already has an opening for your window that is parametric. You can see, you can check out the parameters in this family type window. And as you can see, there's already a height parameter defined and a width parameter defined. And when we change them, the wall opening changes with it. And now what we want to do is create a window within this wall opening. To do this, we click on Create. And here you have this different options to create some kind of form. I would recommend you to be adventurous and try them all out at a time to see how they work. But for now, we are going to need an extrusion to create the frame of our window. We select the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle directly on the lines of the wall opening. Now you see all these little lockets appear, and we close them because we want to lock this rectangle to the edges of the wall opening and thus to the predefined height and width parameter. Now to create the thickness of the frame, we're going to draw a second rectangle. Just draw it somehow. It doesn't matter for now, we're going to change it later. Now if you click on Finish, you see the little uneven frame that we created. You can check out if it's already parametric when you open the parameter box again and then change the height, for example. And you see that it changes with it. Same goes for the width, of course. Let's check that out. Now we already made the height and the width parametric, but we also want the depth of the window to change with the wall thickness. For this, we look at it from the left side or the right side, and we see this is the extrusion that we just created. And the depth of it is defined by this extrusion start and end point. Now, for example, if we change it, yeah, you see that the extrusion the frame gets thicker. But we want it to be as thick as the wall, so we drag it here onto the edge of the wall, and we see another locket appears, and we lock it to the wall thickness. Now we can check if it works. If we click on the wall and change it from 200 millimeters to 300 millimeters, and we see that the frame, the extrusion that we created, changes with it. But as you remember, we're not yet happy with the way our frame looks. So we create a new parameter to define the thickness of the frame. We click on this symbol down here and give it a name, frame thickness. Oops. Now it's going to be a type parameter defining a length grouped under dimension. This is fine. And we see here our new parameter. We give it a default value of 50 and hit OK. Now to connect this new parameter to the actual width of the frame, we're going to double click the extrusion to get back to the edit extrusion mode. And we're going to need some dimensions under annotate. And we create an annotation for every piece of the frame. Now this doesn't have to be pretty. Okay. Now, when you click on one of the dimensions, you can see this label box right here that allows you to connect this dimension to a parameter, and you see our frame thickness right here, and we're going to do this for all of the frame pieces. Okay, now you see it has already changed the frame to an even value of 50. If we hit OK now, we can see that we can change the thickness of the frame when we change this value right here. See? Now the next thing we need is of course the glass for our window. But because we want the glass to be sitting in the middle of the window, we have to select the center front back work plane. To do this, we click on Create, Set Work Plane, and we change it to Center Front Back. Now we create another extrusion with the rectangle tool, and again fix it to the inner corners of the frame. Now we want our glass to be, let's say, 3 centimeters thick. And then we can already finish. We can check out our window in the 3D view to see the glass piece in the middle of our window frame. Now you might see that the glass piece is not yet see-through. This is because, of course, it doesn't know it's supposed to be glass yet. To change this, we're going to assign a material parameter to it. Now, if we click on the extrusion, we see in the properties that there's this material option. We don't click on by category, but we click on this little gray box right next to it. And this is also a way to create a new parameter. We click on this new parameter button right here. And as you can see, it already selected a material as the type of parameter. We're going to name it glass material. Click OK. And now in the parameter box, we see our new material parameter and we can select a material now. And our window becomes see-through. We're going to do the same with the frame. Gray box and new parameter. Frame material. Okay. And change the material to default. Because you're going to select the actual material when you use the window in your project. Now if we take a look at it with consistent colors, we can see it already looks pretty much like a window, huh? Now the last thing we want to do is add a piece of mullion going from top to bottom of the window. So we go back to the exterior view. And you already know how to do this. We create an extrusion. Now, be careful, we have to set the work plane back to exterior. Now we take a rectangle and create the mullion. Now, to make this parametric, we're going to need a parameter for the distance to frame and a parameter for the mullion thickness. And the way I showed you before was now to finish off, then go to the type properties, create the new parameters, and then align them to the mullion. But there is a quicker way to do this. If we draw some dimensions now, so the first one for the distance and the second one for the thickness. When we click on the dimensions now, we can see this label function appearing right here with this shortcut to creating a new parameter. And you see it already has the length selected. We give it a name, mullion distance to frame. Okay, and the second one for the mullion thickness. Okay, and now when we finish off our extrusion, we can find our two new parameters in the family types. Oops, sorry, we can change it to send the mullion to the other side or to make it thinner, let's say 5 centimeters. Yeah, you see. But now, as before with the frame, we also need to take a look at the depth. When we go to left or right view, we find our mullion here, this is it, and we drag it to the outer edge of the wall and lock it just like before with the frame. We can check if it works when we change the thickness of the wall, and we see everything works perfectly fine. Now we also want it to have the same material as the frame. So we select the mullion, and under properties, we go to this little gray box next to material and select frame material. Okay, now I think our window is now ready to be exported into the project. For this, we click on load into project. And we can place our new window on the wall. Now to change all the parameters that we created, we need to create a new type. And you see here all the different parameters that we created on our own, huh? Now, for example, we can create a bigger window with a square shape. And then we can also move the mullion a bit more to the center, maybe. And then, of course, also give the frame a new material. I want to make this a wooden window. And because we use the window template, we also have these predefined parameters like sill height that we can use. Well, yeah. That was it.
So that was it. I hope this was helpful for you. If you do create your own family now, I'd be so excited to see what you came up with. You can send it to me via email. I have my email address in the description box. Or if you're struggling on your way, you can of course always write me and I will try to solve your problem. You can check out my other videos or subscribe to my channel if you like my videos. And bye bye. Take care.